Bloomberg came out with a study and ranks the Philippines 52nd out of 53 economies. So second to the last in terms of a resiliency ranking with the COVID programs. And you heard Secretary Duque, he said it's unfair. It's skewed towards countries who have a lot of supply of vaccine. And he went as far as saying, I'm pissed with this report. So what do you make of that Bloomberg report?
I think, Karen, ang dapat talagang ma-piss off ay hindi yung health secretary, pero yung ating mga mamamayan, not with the Bloomberg report, because it's just the latest reflection of the truth on the ground. Ang talagang nakakabuisit, nakakadismaya sa mamamayan is the very poor health response, and twinning that, the poor economic response. Unfair ba yung Bloomberg report? Mas unfair na this health and economic response has been so poor in protecting our people from the worst effects of COVID-19 and of the recession. Skewed daw towards vaccination administration. But my gosh, yung vaccination is already the fifth in our set of life-saving responses to the COVID pandemic. Last year pa dapat nagpo-procure na tayo or nagsisignify ng intention to procure in addition to what we would be receiving through COVAX. Yung unang apat na steps nga, Karen, test, trace, isolate, or quarantine and treat. Hanggang ngayon, we haven't come up to speed with that, and vaccination is just already the fifth step. Sisisihin pa ba natin yung Bloomberg? Hey, they're just doing their duty as a very, you know, dispassionate, hard-nosed economic publication and monitor. Rather than getting mad at Bloomberg, we should step up. Kasi hindi naman Bloomberg ang ikanga nag-drop ng ball. I'm sorry. It was the health department under the leadership of the good secretary that has been dropping the ball so far.
Okay. On another issue, you have been calling for a national day for the West Philippine Sea. All right. Let's talk briefly about this, and how important is this, you feel?
It is so important. The West Philippine Sea alone is so important in terms of marine and energy resources for our country. And then that signal victory at The Hague in 2016, it signaled that the world, under the United Nations Convention on the Law of the Sea, recognizes and with the Philippines upholds our national sovereignty in the West Philippine Sea vis-a-vis that regional giant, China. So I felt, Karen, it was time through the Senate resolution to call for a special day and other activities to, you know, imarka talaga sa kalooban ng bawat Pilipino itong tagumpay natin.
And so that the next generations will know, right?
The next generations.
They will not lose memory of the victory.
They will not lose memory in the face of this wave of disinformation and misinformation about our victory in terms of the West Philippine Sea. At para din, Karen, magunita ng bawat Pilipino na, you know, in the face again of all the dis and misinformation, you know, it was the late President Noy who is the father of our victory at The Hague in terms of the West Philippine Sea. He's a true patriot, at dapat magunita natin taon-taon, July 12, itong tagumpay natin tungkol sa West Philippine Sea, at na si Pinoy ang ama niyan.
I'm curious, are you seeing that passed within this administration?
Yes, it passed in the early days, the opening days of this administration.
Okay.
Dahil sa kasong hinain nung nakaraang administrasyon, nung 2012, and you know, binuno nila over the next 4 years solidly. And then finally, in the opening days of this administration, hinand down yung winning ruling in our favor.
No, I'm meaning itong National Day. Do you believe that that will pass?
I'm so sorry. Oh, well, of course, a resolution is always seeking a consensus, and I hope that my colleagues in the Senate will see the political and the moral import of this. At syempre, pagdating na ng isang batas sa desk ng Pangulo, he will have to assess the merits of this law. And if and when he signs it into law, makinig din siya sa sentimiento ng karamihan ng mga mamamayan. If and when he signs it into law, well, finally, Karen, it will signal his loyalty to the Philippines and not to China.
Okay. My last question is the 2022 elections. Mm-hmm. You have senior members of the party, someone like Senator Franklin Drilon, mm-hmm. already saying he'll retire. Right? Mm-hmm. He'll retire and just wait for a post. You have Vice President Lenny Robredo, who is unsure of running. Where are you seeing yourself, Senator Risa, in 2022? I'm assuming, of course, you will seek re-election.
Yes, I'll be seeking re-election to the Senate, Karen. Again, carrying my certificate of candidacy from Akbayan Party, my party. And even now, looking back on the past 2 years, na mga one-on-one talks among different parties and even different individuals, seeing itong recent na pagsulpot ng initiative ng isang bayan. Looking forward in the next several months to many more talks among different formations, parties, individuals.
Ang inaasahan ko, Karen, do you feel disheartened somewhat? I mean,
I have no right to feel disheartened. Okay. I feel all the more, Karen, yung tungkulin ko bilang isang, hindi lang politiko, bilang isang aktivista, to hope and to contribute that hope actively into towards what I see and how I see myself also in the next months. Gusto kong maging bahagi ng isang united front. Isang mas malawak na pagkakaisa, not just among us usual suspects, opposition, but a broader unity among Filipinos. Lahat tayo na kahit hindi opposition, basta na gusto ng isang ibang klase at mas mabuting administrasyon. And you know, Karen, as speaking about recent results of focus group discussions, karamihan ng mga mamamayan natin actually hindi pa iniisip talaga ang election because of the pressure of the pandemic and the recession. Yeah. So tingin ko, ang hinahanap talaga ng mga tao is for government to give solutions, lalo na tungkol sa kabuhayan at syempre pati tungkol sa kalusugan. And that's what I hope a broader unity of us Filipinos in a united front will be presenting now, in the next months, at sa susunod na election. Doon tayo sana magkaisang lahat or karamihan.
All right. Senator Risa Ontiveros, I do hope to have you back on Head Start so we can talk much longer. But I want to thank you, Senator, for being on the show today. Thank you.
Take care. Stay healthy.